I'm Graham Horton. Welcome to my product review for the Hohem BM01 Bluetooth mic, their compatible smartphone app, the Hohem Pro, and their compatible gimbals, which I've listed on screen for you now. Well, first of all, why would you want to use the BM01 Bluetooth mic? Well, if you're using a gimbal and you want to get good audio, you need to use an external microphone. You've got the options of using a lavalier microphone, which will be a wired type, but then you have the dongle required to go to your smartphone, and then you've got the length of cable required to connect your smartphone to your lavalier mic mounted on your shirt collar or something like that. So you've got that extra cable hanging down, which could get trapped into the mechanisms of the gimbal, or it could appear in shot. Now, in the past, I've used this type of dongle. It's a 2.4 gigahertz wireless dongle. The receiver plugs into the lightning port or your USB-C port of the smartphone, and then the microphone clips to your shirt as you would normally with a radio mic. The problem is with this that you cannot use the gimbal in its vertical mode because this interferes with the cradle, so you can't use it for your vertical format like TikTok videos. So when the option came to try out the BM01 mic from Hohem, I jumped at it because I wanted to first of all establish whether Bluetooth microphones were of sufficient quality for this sort of recording and whether they would act as a suitable input for vlogging and other applications. So let's have a look at the BM01 mic. It's supplied in this very Apple-esque looking box. Got a magnetic catch on the cover, which is a nice feature. Inside you'll find a basic user's guide, but on the lid of this device you also see the working instructions for getting this unit up and operational. There's also the QR codes here to download the manuals. This is the actual smart mic itself, and if I just take it out, have a closer look. See, it's a very small device, roughly about 60 millimeters by 20 millimeters by about 9 millimeters thick, and it weighs very little. On the front of the mic we have a dual function switch. The lower portion is for turning the microphone on and off and for some functions associated with the gimbal. The top button is the function switch, and again associated with picture taking and listening to your audio through your music device. Again, various functions of that top switch, which I'll go through in a moment. On the top of the microphone, you can just see the microphone port, which is a small hole. On the bottom of the device is our USB-C port, which is used for charging the device and also for attaching these earpieces, which are used for either monitoring your audio in real time, so you can actually listen to the audio that you're recording, or it can be used for taking and receiving phone calls over your smartphone or listening to music. Also in this little compartment is the usual USB-A to USB-C charging lead. In the upper portion, we've got our wind muff, which can be fixed to the microphone to enable you to use this outdoors and cut down on the amount of noise. The microphone does have a convenient clip, so you can clip it to your belt or onto your shirt pocket, or onto your lapel, whichever you prefer to get good audio. The last component here are a couple of different size of soft earbuds to go on the receivers there. So this device is a Bluetooth device, so its range isn't as good as the wireless transmitters. These can go up to something like 50 or 60 meters line of sight. You're probably limited to something like 15 meters, but for most applications, that's the furthest distance you'll ever want to use. And again, I'll try that distance test for you in this video. So the microphone has its own inbuilt lithium-ion battery, rated at 3.7 volts and 150 milliamp hours. It takes roughly an hour to charge and will run between 4 and 5 hours once it's fully charged. To get full feature set from this device, you'll be using the Hohem Pro app and in conjunction with a compatible gimbal. But it will work on its own with the Hohem Pro app. You don't have to use it with the Hohem compatible gimbal. So if you just wanted to use this to record using the standard camera app or something like Filmic Pro for better video quality, you can use this mic. You won't get all the feature set like the noise cancellation that is built into the Hohem Pro app, but you can actually do that in your post-processing for your video so you can get good audio from this device should you need it. So to get this device working, we obviously need to power it on and to connect it to our smartphone. So what I'm going to do is go into my smartphone and we'll start recording. So now we're recording the screen. We're going to go into the settings and into Bluetooth. And now I'm going to turn on the mic by pressing the lower switch and holding that for 3 seconds. There are LEDs in here which give you an indication of the mode that it's in. That would be my first complaint, that these LEDs aren't really bright enough. But saying we've only got a 150 milliamp hour battery in there, I guess they wanted to try and conserve battery power and not enable these LEDs at such a bright level. You can see now on the Bluetooth connection, we've got a Hohem smart mic being detected. So I'll just click on that and it will start the pairing process. And there we can see it's now in the Bluetooth list and it's connected. So now we can come out of the setup and go into the Hohem Pro app. And to enable the microphone in that app, we go to the gear icon at the bottom and choose the microphone, which is the microphone symbol at the bottom. And there you can see all the options for this mic. So you can enable it or use again the internal microphone of your smartphone. The microphone gain is set to automatic, but you can actually change that to a manual setting if you want to check your own levels. leave that in automatic for the moment. The monitor allows you to set the volume of the audio in the earbuds, so you can actually monitor your input. The noise cancellation can be off, low, medium or high, depending on the amount of ambient noise. And you've got the option now to mix between a audio track that's running on your smartphone and your audio that's coming from the microphone. So you can actually mix between the two and you can actually set the volume with the mic mixer. But for now, I'm going to have the mic mixer off. We're not going to be mixing any music. So we're just going to be using the microphone with the automatic gain. So I can now come into the application and you can see that it's already selected face tracking. And if I move around, it isn't doing anything because we've not enabled face tracking per se. So to enable face tracking, I'm going to just click that little face track symbol and click the little icon at the top. And now if I use the lower button and do a single click, that will turn on and off face tracking. So a single click will actually turn off face tracking. You can see on the screen, we're not face tracking anymore. If I just click one more time, it will go back into face tracking. And again, the gimbal will be able to follow me around. The upper switch is our function switch, and we can click that once to take a photo or start video recording. So if I press that once, we'll get the countdown timer and the smartphone will now be recording video. And in this case, we're recording at 4K 30 on the iPhone 12 Pro. Now, one thing I would like in the app is to be able to recenter your face at any point of the screen rather than being in the center of the screen. At the moment, there's a little bit too much headroom there. Obviously, with 4K, I can crop into that and get the composition right. But if you're in 1080p, you've not got very much to play with. So it would be nice if you could actually set the face a little bit further up the frame. To stop recording, again, just one click of the button and that will stop the video recording. If I double click that function switch, it will switch between photo and video. And I don't know why this app takes a photograph when you've done that. And I don't know why you get this green box that's not on a face. It looks as though it's sort of object tracking, but out of place. Maybe it's just an iOS device problem. I haven't tried this with an Android phone, but I don't normally use it in the photo mode. All my operations are done in video mode. Go back to video with a double click. So we've now come back to video. You can see that box is centered again on my face. Triple click will change the front and rear cameras. At the moment we're on the front camera, which is a forward facing one. Triple click will switch over to the rear camera. You can see my very untidy studio at the moment. Triple click will put it back to the selfie mode. And then back to the selfie mode. So you could use all the manual controls on the gimbal. So if you're using this gimbal handheld, you can use the controls on the gimbal, as this would be on your shirt collar. So I went out yesterday and did a walk in a local wood using the Hohem iSteady X gimbal, using this Bluetooth wireless microphone, and recorded some clips for you. So you can see the audio quality, the amount of noise cancellation. It was quite a windy day and I think it fared fairly well. You could obviously post-process this audio to give you better audio, but for most people, you're going to be using the audio straight from the microphone into your video clip and without any adjustment. So we're just coming down to one of the big lakes and we'll go right and make our way back to the car park. Is normally where you see the kingfisher in this pool. There's a perch there that's suddenly stuck in the mud, hopefully to try and capture the kingfisher at some point. And see the swans and the cygnets on the lake. Obviously someone feeding them over there as the ducks and cygnets are making their way over. Now I'm very happy to see there's virtually no latency in the audio and video. So if there was some latency, you would have to resync the audio in your editor to enable this lip sync to take place. You can monitor in real time the audio coming from the microphone. So if I plug in my earbuds here, on your short cable, you don't really want a long cable. So I plug this in. And I can plug this into the port. And now I can monitor the audio. And if I wanted to change the volume, then again, I can go into the settings and into the microphone setting and change the monitor level at the moment. So I'm full where I can change the volume. Because there's no latency, it isn't echoing in my ear. So it does mean I can carry on a conversation without being distracted with an echo that's going on in your ear. So you can actually hear if you've got any extraneous noise from fans running or people in the background. You can then adjust that with the noise cancellation. If I wanted to start recording, then I'll just need to press the upper switch with one click. The video will count down. And now we're recording onto the smartphone and recording the audio so you can hear from the microphone the quality recording into your Hohem Pro app. Now the book does say that this will only work with the Hohem Pro app, and it only works with that with full feature set of the switch functions and that sort of thing. But the Bluetooth microphone will work with a number of other applications. It will actually work with something like Filmic Pro. So if you're into using higher quality video recordings using Filmic Pro, you can switch over and use this Bluetooth mic. You haven't got the feature set like the noise cancellation, but you can set the noise, audio level, which is basically what you want to do. And then if you want to do any parameter adjustments, you can do that in post-processing. You can also use this with some of the native phone apps like note-taking. So you can actually use this to audio note-taking. And in some circumstances, you can use this in a speech-to-text program. So you can actually dictate an email or you can dictate a note using a speech-to-text program. It will also work with other native applications which do support an external microphone. It's just a case of discovering which you can use. It doesn't work with the native camera app, unfortunately, as I've not found a way of introducing the Bluetooth microphone into that, but there may be a method that some of you can discover. It may be different again between iOS and the Android systems as well. So I've come outside now and we're going to test the range of this Bluetooth microphone. The suggested range is up to 50 meters, currently about 1 meter away. So using the OM app, now I'm about 2 meters away. So I'm going to go about 5 meters away, which would be probably the furthest distance you'd ever want to be using this microphone at anyway. So let's go to about 5 meters. So that's about 5 meters away. That's probably the greatest distance you're ever going to want to use this microphone at. One of the problems with 2.4 gigahertz wireless microphones is when you turn your back on the camera, you'll actually lose the RF transmission. So I'm not sure that's the case with Bluetooth. So let me just turn around. And we may have lost the Bluetooth. Take two, come in. So that's about 10 meters away. That is way, way beyond the range of what you're going to be using this. You'll be such a small item on the screen anyway that you probably wouldn't want that for your vlogging anyway. So 10 meters is more than adequate. And coming back to about 5 meters there, and a normal sort of distance would be around about a meter or a meter and a half away. The iSteady has actually picked up again and we're still face tracking. So it is a good system, and hopefully the Bluetooth audio is good enough for most applications. Do some comparative recording now of the audio using a variety of devices. Now, the first one I'm going to be using is this wireless microphone, the 2.4 gigahertz model. It's one by Zufon. It's a lightning adapter plugged into the port of the camera. Using the OM Smart app and using the internal mic setting, so you're actually recording audio from this device. So the next test is using the Zufon 2.4 gigahertz wireless system. The transmitter plugged onto my shirt there. The receiver is plugged into the lightning port. So you've got a wireless transmission system just to see the audio quality from this system compared to the smart mic from Hohem. So now we're recording using the lavalier microphone, which is a wired device. I actually got the lightning to TRS dongle plugged in so I can actually connect this microphone. So here's an audio sample using just the wired lavalier microphone. Of course, you're going to have that dangling cable, which may get entangled with the Hohem Go gimbal, or if you're using this on its own, you could be using this handheld. So audio sample from just the wired lavalier microphone. This is a test now using the internal microphones only of the iPhone 12 Pro, just to give you some idea of the audio quality in this sort of ambient environment. So here we have now the audio from the Hohem smart mic. I've removed the windshield just in case it was attenuating any of the high frequencies, but here we have the audio sample from the smart mic into the iPhone 12 using the Hohem Pro app. So there we are, that's my quick review of the BM01 microphone from Hohem. Does seem to work quite nicely with the Hohem Pro app and the associated Hohem gimbal. So if you were using this app for your vlogging, then of course you can move around quite happily and the thing will face track you. If you wanted to object track, then it will have an object track. And you've got all the feature sets of the gimbal there. If you wanted to use it like pan follow or tilt follow or all point of view follow, you've got all those features of the gimbal. But as I say, you can use this without the gimbal. You can use it with your smartphone if you just wanted a remote microphone and not be bothered with all those cables or a dongle to be fussed with. Well, that's it for the review. Thanks very much for watching. And if you are a new viewer, why not click that subscribe button and the bell notification icon to be advised when I upload new videos. So until my next review, thanks very much for watching. Please do take care and I'll see you all very, very soon. Goodbye for now.